These are memory made. You learn from an individual
particular panel, for example, all the text says is that the seizure of blade slipped through. And I don't know about you guys, but that doesn't really tell me all that much about how to do this move. However, being a swordsman in the medieval period was a martial art, in the exact same way as someone who would study karate or jiu-jitsu is a martial artist today. So combining all the different manuals that survived that we know of from the period, and combining these with modern day martial art techniques, we've come up with a pretty good interpretation, a pretty good idea of how people were actually fighting throughout this period. And to show you that, we just did a sword fight for you, one that we think accurately represents the fight. Now what we'll do is we're just going to go through the fight we showed you again, but this time do it slowly and just talk you through the individual moves and the individual targets that we're actually going for so you can understand exactly what's happening. Now you can see that we're fighting in a little arena here. It's a fight arena, much the same as a boxing arena is, like boxing ring is today. It's got lots of fences on. The first fence is so that either of us can't run away. And the second fence is so that you guys don't get hurt. The sword comes flying across the first barrier. No one's hopefully going to have their head cut off. This is a safety feature actually used in the medieval period as well. Now, if you are fighting in this sort of arena, you're doing it for one of two reasons. Tournament or a fight to the death, probably to solve a law or matter, something along those lines. We're not fighting to the death, I actually quite like Scott. So we're just going to pretend it's a tournament fight. We're showing off our skill, trying to prove to you guys which one of us is the better fighter. Now, because it's a one-on-one fight, it gives us the opportunity to take up a guard position, a starting position. The guard I'm going to take is known as the Fool's Guard, because I've got my blade pointed towards the ground, leaving my entire upper body exposed to attack, just like a fool. Of course, if Scott hasn't read the same manual as I have, or perhaps just inexperienced, and attacks me head on, all I do is step out of the way and lift up my blade, skewering me on the end. Him fool, not me.
Now, I've never decided to turn myself into a walking shish kebab, so I need to figure out a way around Mike's defence. So I'm going to take a Kerniger or a crab stance, some good aggressive stance, but I'm only going to test his defences. I'm going to come down and try and take his leg off a bit of the neck.
So, because he's just testing me out, it was not the strongest attack. All I need to do is step out of the way. Now, I am going to turn the blade to the side just to be on the safe side. And I need to figure out what kind of fighter Scott is now. So all I'm going to do is mimic him. Twist my blade around my head and try and cut to the back of the knee, so we're in attendance.
So Mike might as well work for me as well. I'm going to do the exact same thing.
Now, because that was his first real attack, it was actually a pretty strong one, so simply moving out of the way might not be good enough. What I've done to ensure my safety then is placed my blade above my head in a sloping direction. This means if Scott does make contact with my blade, his will slide away from my body. Now, I can still see Scott through this lovely little window of faith for myself, and it's telling me that now his blade's over there, his neck is exposed. So I'm just going to try and swing around and sever the top of his spine.
So now the fight's come to a complete stop. I've stopped Mike's blade with the strongest part of mine, the forte, against Mike's sharpest bit, but his weakest part of the sword as well, the femur or the foible. So now it's going to be the most skilled, the quickest, the most elegant of the two fighters that takes over. I shall take over. I'm going to knock the sword up and slash across his exposed stomach.
Well, that does give me an advantage of my blade, actually. But in doing so, I'm going to use that half swording technique, grabbing hold of my own blade and maybe probably as close to his guts. Oof. Right eyeball. Right, well, I've pushed him backwards, he's on the run, I'm going to get him in the corner, so I'm pressing my advantage, I'm going to go for his left eyeball.
So if I get back to inside corner, I'm in big trouble. I'm stuck, and if I'm stuck, I'm dead. So I need to regain the initiative and retake momentum. So from here, fly slide his sword nicely out of the way so his body is exposed and try and skewer him.
Jumping out of the way, clipping the blade to the side. The fight has gone on far too long. We need to end it now. So what I'm going to do now is swing my blade around to perform a heavy attack on Scott's head, hopefully splitting it in two.
So again, it worked for Mike earlier, it'll work for me now. I've opened up his entire body and can swing around and take his head off.
And I step backwards, blocking it. Now there are a few things I could do here. In blocking the attack, I can angle my blade towards Scott, allowing for a pretty quick and nasty thrust towards Scott's face. But I'm not going to do that, that's far too easy. Instead, I'm going to do something pretty stupid. Taking a leaf out of Tower Hopper's book, I'm going to block like so, and grab hold of Scott's blade. And with a swift motion, twist Scott's blade out of his hand. No blade, no victory for Scott. Now, now, that is just one way that the fight could go. Any small variation in any of those moves could create a different end. I could win sooner, I could win later. Scott might even win. Maybe.
Does happen.
So you never know. Thing is, in reality, fights are very, very quick. They might only last two or three moves, but that wouldn't be very fun for you guys, so we have pulled it out a little bit to make a bit of a show. Now, what we'll do is we'll run through that fight at full speed so you get to see it, but we will try and throw a different move or two in, so mix it up a bit to see what actually happens, see what the result is at the end. So wish me luck. Today, and I hope you've been